Welcome to the fourth episode of our Science Excite Lockroom series. Today is 11th May and we are celebrating National Technology Day. Actually, in May 11th, 1998, India successfully tested nuclear bomb in Pokhran range, and a glorious chapter is added in the history of India's technological innovation. Now, it is commemorated every year and honoring the architect of such innovation. Such innovation is a classic example of multidisciplinary collaboration. Today, in the era of automation, almost every product uses that multidisciplinary approach. Even for a very simple household product, it is used. For example, this has changed the journey of a hot metal plate into an automatic iron and folding machine. So, our today's discussion will be on iron, which is an important but non-essential household item. It's really impossible to say when people started pressing cloth. From some historic evidences, it is believed that Chinese were using hot metal for ironing before anyone else. Thousands years ago, the method was already well established. Then, for many years, people all over the globe use different version of cold waste iron, and finally in 1882 W. Shaley invented electric iron. Till today, electric iron we use, that also uses the same principle, though many advancement happened in the form of safety and user interactive features, but the basic technology of iron remained same. It only uses an electric heater inside it that heats the metal plate below it. So simple. Necessarily, it's just a common heating mechanism. But with this technology, we could able to achieve so nice effect in our clothes. So our today's question is how? How only a hot iron can smooth our clothes, but a cold iron cannot? Welcome to the answering session. As usual, before answering, we'll be performing some experiment. First, we need to know that our cloths are composed of long chain of molecules that exist in polymer fiber. For better visualization of ironing effect, we'll be using a piece of plastic wire first, then a synthetic cloth, and lastly a cotton cloth. Let us consider this wire as a zoom version of your single fiber inside your synthetic cloth. First, we should try bending it, but it's not remaining in the position. Now it's time to give heat. See, it's flexible. It's because heat has loosened up the ties between the long chain of polymers that exist in fiber material. Now if we give some shape to it and make it cool, it will remain in the position. The same thing happens with all fiber in a synthetic cloth when it is pressed with heated iron, and we get a smooth surface. This cannot happen with a cold iron. Though for full cotton cloth, heat up the iron used in a different way. Here we need water for loosening up the ties of long chain polymer. See, this piece of full cotton cloth I have tried with iron directly, but it does not work effectively. Now after giving water, it becomes flexible, and hot iron is used to remove the water by evaporation. After removing the water, it becomes stiff and remained in the new shape that is given during heating. So for this case also, evaporation cannot be done using a cold iron. Hence, a hot iron is necessary for smoothing our cloths. Someone may have a question about wrinkle-free cloths. Actually, there also they use the same principle. The material is modified to have a high flexibility. Hence, even its own weight can make it straight if kept vertical. Enough for today. So still, if you have any question, you can write to us at shatadal88@gmail.com. Thanks for watching. Namaskar.